Ukeria Anunobi speaks on hygiene issues and being vindicated, sharing a footage of a journalist who uncovered a hygiene breach in three top hotels in northeast China. She recounted her experience with a production assistant and a hotel cleaner. She said, and I quote, "I made a post of how I physically witnessed a movie production assistant use a toilet cleaning liquid to wash the plate. I asked him to wash for me, and how I also saw a hotel cleaner in one of the hotels at Reading Camp, where I had gone for a retreat, use the toilet brush to wash the glass cups. People said in comments that I had been economical with the truth. Isn't it great to have this video? Shame on naysayers always." End of quotes.
Okay. Honestly, when I watched the video, at first I wanted to give the people the toilets, the whole toilet brush thing. I wanted to give them a benefit of doubt. And maybe it was a different toilet brush that they used. Maybe they just used it maybe to make it faster. But then I watched the video and I said that it was the same toilet. The brush that they used to wash the toilet is the same brush they used to wash the cup, the same brush they used to wash the, you know, the basin. And I was like, okay, well, this is an issue that should bring up concerns, because you don't know what goes on in these hotels. I'm going to an hotel to have a nice time. I'm going to an hotel to rest and do all that. I'm not expecting that when I'm leaving, I should be worried about my health because of the things that the hotel workers are doing. So I wonder if there are regulations in these hotels, because it's not just in China.
Yeah, they,
according to Nigeria, it happens in Nigeria.
They warned, they told them, I mean, they give them sanctions and
fine
that was not available to the public, but yeah. Something has been done, but I hope that is enough to make them do the right thing, because like you said, I'm going to a hotel to have a good time, and in my head I kind of believe that okay, everything there is neat and cool, I can use it. I know I have friends that are finicky about using the towels. They tell you they don't use towels in hotels, so when they're going they have their own towels, but for me I'm like, I mean, I want
this. We have friends that steal the towels when you leave.
I mean, we have both sides, right? So I want the stress-free life. I don't want to go there and then still pack my personal belongings while checking into a hotel where I've paid good money for. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, but bringing it back to what Ukeria was saying, she said the person used a toilet washing liquid to wash the plate instead of a normal dishwashing. whatever it's called. So she also mentioned the person using, is it the toilet brush?
Yeah, toilet brush in Redeem Hotel.
Okay. So I know people were asking and saying, is it really wrong to use the toilet cleaning detergent when you know you're going to rinse it properly?
It's wrong.
I mean I needed us to emphasize
how wrong it is.
You know,
because there are different chemicals in the dishwashing liquid and the one they use for toilet. I expect that the one they use for dishwashing
you
can use it for the toilet if you want.
They even advise that you shouldn't use detergent to wash
your plates. Because of the chemicals that are inside, the chemicals are they are not the kind that you are, that because some of the times when wash this plate, you don't know, sometimes you don't rinse it properly and there can still be sediments of these chemicals on the plate. If you are using something as caustic as the ingredients that are found in detergents or the soaps that are used to wash toilet, then you are setting up yourself for health hazard.
Yeah, which is why they're saying it's okay for you to try to use the dishwashers to wash
for
your
the toilet. It's fine,
but it's not fine the other way around. So and from what I saw, there's an acid used in making those things used for the toilet and the towels. You know, you can also use them for the towels as well, because they are really strong, and it's called hydrochloric acid. Like, that's one of the active ingredients, so that is like really strong. But when it comes to the dishwashers, they use sodium carbonate, which is basically salt and limestone together. You get, so please if you maybe thought it is nice and okay, it's just a foam, maybe it's foam and let me wash, it doesn't work like that, because your water might not be able to really rinse it. It's acid.
Yeah,
it's not just alkaline and all that,
and these chemicals are not supposed to be ingested into your body. So people should be careful.
Okay,
so it's not just about hotels, if you ask me. Sometimes you walk to restaurants, very fancy restaurants at that, and then you don't even know what they're doing in the kitchen. Yeah. First of all, some of them use the same pots that they used to cook certain things, and they probably didn't wash it all day, but because they're about to cook that same thing, yeah, they'll use it again. It's I've true. Seen that happen before.
Do
you understand? Like, the person did not wash the pot that was used to make stew, and I think that has been left the stew to go. You understand? They now poured what they wanted to use to cook jollof rice. So I can imagine the flies that had perched on that. And I walked away from that place. Now, another thing is that you see a lot of people, you know, somebody posted something, I think, sometime last week, saying that just know that every time you walk into a restaurant, the utensils you use, like your fork and all of that, has been used by more than 1,000 people. And that got me thinking. So I'm like, okay, so if I'm going to a restaurant now, but thank God for the plastic. So even when I go to a fancy restaurant and then you're about to give me a stainless, I ask you, do you have plastic? Do you have disposable spoons? Because I just have this mind state now, because at the end of the day, you see people with lots of germs in their mouth, bad dentition, bad this, bad that, and they keep putting that same thing, and then I'm supposed to walk into that same restaurant and use that same fork.
Well, I think this is why this type of reports, I'm not saying it's wrong, it's absolutely necessary, it becomes a cause for concern, like you said, because when you go to a certain places, you want to expect that they hold hygiene to a certain standard. The kind of restaurant you're talking about now that has the cutlery setting and all that, we will want to hope and believe
that
they are washing it.
Because they don't even wash. No, they just wet a rag and they wipe.
They do.
You, and they put it back. I'm not generalizing. I'm saying that, look, the same way, okay, Gigi here, the China reporter who uncovered this hotel store, she said most of this hotel attendants that did this thing, they said it's a constant rush. They have a particular target. Okay, maybe they tell you between 10 to 12, you have to clean like 12 rooms, 14 rooms. So they're actually trying to rush. It's not like they're not aware they're supposed to use a different van, but they're trying to, because once it's 12 o'clock, the hotel manager will probably walk up to them and be like, you've just done 4 rooms. Do you understand? That's because you're trying to keep up. So at the end of the day, I think the slave labor should also be reduced, like employ more people to do certain jobs so that you can get the quality. It's about quality of service and not the quantity of things they can do in a short time. So at the end of the day, I would advise most restaurants to please have disposable cutlery. I'm paying a huge sum of money for my food. The least you can do for me is make sure that I'm safe.
Disposable cutlery, like
disposable cutlery.
No, they're strong ones.
Okay,
they're strong ones. That's what I'm saying. Invest in disposable cutlery. Do you understand?
Do you think it's cheaper for them to invest in disposable cutlery as regards or against them having more hands? Like you said, more hands to at least reduce the level of work they need to do and ensure.
Do you know how much a pack of disposable cutlery are?
The ones you're talking about that would be as comfortable.
Yes, cheaper.